I mean, I don't know if I would want to say it's like a talent, because I always knew that like I was capable of drawing things. I just didn't know if it was things that people actually like thought were funny or like wanted to see. So, I mean, just when people were like, oh, that's funny, like I was like, okay, I like being funny. Or, I mean, just like, you know, the stuff where it's like, just like kind of appraised the skateboarding. Like everyone knows that. Everyone can relate to that if you're a skateboarder. If you can illustrate it instead of just being like, skateboarding's cool, why not? My mom, she went to art school and she just said, you know, it's not really worth it. You might as well just go get another degree. I figured I would do that because a lot of people too, just that I know that go to art school just say it kind of just like kills your creativity. And I don't ever want this to seem like a job or anything. A marker box. Getting a little full, I can barely close it now. I'd say a lot of the influence as to why I even started was probably just like working at the shop and seeing like just like the variety of people that come in and like some of the shit that I get asked.
You guys got penny boards? You guys got penny grip?
How good do I sell longboards? I mean, how well do I sell longboards? Pardon the grammar on that one. So this is the setup. This is it. Like when I come into work, he just gets so bummed out because I just come over here, set up all my shit. I mean, if we have downtime, I'll like sit over here. But like, I'm not like a huge dickhead and just like hang out here the whole fucking time, like doing all my shit. Here's one. Okay, I'll show you this one because I didn't want to post it. So the original inspiration for this one was two nights ago, my roommate, Colin, got really drunk and he was trying to actually rip my throat out. And then I woke up and I was like, throat rip, that's funny. I mean, I've heard so many people say it before that some of my earlier stuff and even some of my stuff now might look like the Gonz or something like that. That's cool because I definitely draw a lot of influence from him. I'm definitely not trying to like replicate anyone's style or anything, but I like took a figure drawing class down in Westchester with like nude models and stuff. The way the guy explained it was like, if you can draw a human figure, you can draw whatever you want. And this is kind of just like, I figure I almost kind of get the same proportions, but at least just like the way the body moves and stuff like that, it's kind of just like a dumbed down version of, you know, a human figure. It's actually me. I don't know if a lot of people know that. That's the same color shirt because I wear the same color shirt every day. When I'm thinking about drawing it, one of the coolest things I think is like just figuring out how people can contort themselves on a skateboard. Like I was saying how I wanted to draw someone doing a switch ollie, but how do you draw a character doing a switch ollie when no one knows what the character's stance is? So I've seen Jerry Sue switch ollie before and I can tell it's a switch ollie by the way he does it. Like if every month was as good as the last couple months, just as far as like the response I've gotten, then yeah, I think I could definitely continue to do this and really, I mean, I don't know how I feel about like quote unquote building a brand. Cause I always see it as just like me doing art. It's sick. Like, especially when like companies that, you know, that I've always supported and been down for, like Baker reposted one of my things and I was like, holy shit, that's so crazy. Baker, used to watch Baker 3 like every fucking day. It's just like a confirmation that like, cool, you should keep doing this.